soldier was worth it?
Well, first of all, Don, it matters a lot whether he's a deserter or not. Do I prejudge him at this stage, or should any of us as Americans? Absolutely not. Look, it's part of our ethos to go after. If it's man overboard, you don't ask, did he fall over? Was he pushed over? Was he drunk? Or how? It's man overboard, and you pull him out. It's Private Ryan, and people die going after prisoners, and there will be an accountability. It matters a lot whether he was a deserter, but right now, first things first, and that is to recover him.
General Kimmett, to you now, you think this was a horrible deal, but you also say that it should have been done, correct?
No, I agree with Joe Reeder. There's no doubt that we should have done everything in our power to bring any soldier off the battlefield back. We have left them behind in the past. The North Korean, the American who deserted, went across the line into North Korea and stayed there for many, many years. We didn't make the effort to do that, so it's not been holistic over the years. But whenever we have the opportunity to bring a soldier back, we have a moral obligation, not only for that particular soldier, but also for all future soldiers that we put on the battlefield, that they know that their country will be with them throughout.
It seems that most members of the military and people who have served have had similar sentiments. So maybe the criticism that we have been seeing, Gloria Borger, is mostly coming from the political side. So let's go to you. The Daily Beast is reporting tonight that Hillary Clinton opposed this deal when it was being debated, even as far back as 2011, 2012, Gloria. The Taliban detainees were deemed too high of a risk, you know, we reported that, to release in the past. So what happened to change this calculation?
Look, as General Kimmett just said, I do not believe that there's a political discussion about whether the United States should have tried to bring Bowe Bergdahl home. Everybody kind of agrees, of course, that is what we do. I think the political questions that are being asked are, first of all, was this the right deal? Was it a good deal? And that's the question that, according to reporting tonight in the Daily Beast and Time Magazine, that was debated internally at the administration for quite some time, and the administration was divided on that. And I think that, you know, that's a big issue, which is, was it the right deal to strike? Did we strike it with some really bad guys who are going to come back and hurt us again? And the second issue here in Washington is, should the president actually have consulted with Congress? And this is part of a whole issue with President Obama. When you have the Democratic chairwoman of the Senate Intelligence Committee, and I'm stressing Democratic here, say that this was a problem that she needed to know about because she had been in discussions about this over the years, I think it makes you wonder, gee, wouldn't the White House have been wiser, forgetting the legality? I believe the president probably does have the right to do this. Would it have been wiser for the White House to have brought people inside this decision?
Yeah, and I think you're exactly right on that. And as I said here, you really don't have to go out of your way to politicize this. Democrats are upset about it. Republicans are upset about it as well. So, Michael, to you, back on the battlefield, as an Army Special Forces officer, you commanded units involved in the search for Bowe Bergdahl in 2009. Does it really make a difference to you if he left on his own or if he went missing?
It absolutely makes a difference. I was out on the ground leading a number of special forces teams, conducting our missions, everything from reconstruction operations to getting ready for the Afghan presidential elections in 2009 to hunting Taliban commanders. And we stopped everything when Sergeant Bergdahl went missing and stopped everything and went after him. Men died searching for Sergeant Bergdahl, and we believed at the time and still believe today that he deserted his post. Makes a huge difference whether you're going after someone because they were captured on the battlefield or because they left voluntarily and walked into the hands of the enemy.
Do you think he should have been brought home safely? Would you have gone to get him?
Absolutely. Listen, when we deploy overseas, we know there's a likelihood we could get captured. We also know that the United States will do everything in its power, everything in its in the power of the United States government to bring us home. But we also know that we're not going to be bargained for. There won't be a ransom. There won't be terrorists, in this case, the Taliban war cabinet. As one Afghan told me earlier today, the Charles Mansons of Afghan society handed over for us. So no one disputes and no one is arguing that Sergeant Bergdahl should have been brought home, but we are questioning the price that we paid for him.